Clearview Media Sports. We are here with All-American Daryl Peterson, Senior Hoban.
Yes, sir.
How you doing today, dear?
I'm good, man. How you doing?
Good, good. Man, appreciate you coming out, you know, spending your time, giving us some time so we could talk to you. You've been up to a lot, man.
Yes, sir.
You've been playing football basically all your life, right?
Since first grade.
Yes, sir. Let's talk a little bit about that. Tell us about some of your first experiences with football.
I didn't want to play. I was always, my dad played basketball in college, so I was always just basketball. And then I had a classmate whose dad was a coach of the Pee Wee team, and I was bigger than everybody back then. So he kind of just told my mom about it. I went out and played and then ended up liking it.
So this is on a Pee Wee level?
Yeah.
Who'd you play Pee Wee ball with first?
The Akron Chargers.
Okay, the Chargers.
Yeah.
Okay. You got out there, got your first couple hits or whatever.
That's what made me fall in love with it, man. I like hitting people.
Oh, you like hitting people?
Yeah.
All right. Inflicting pain.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. So far as home, like you said, your dad, like, talk about the relationship between you and your dad. Talk about that.
My dad is the big reason for all of this. He just instilled my work ethic more than anything. You know, always put me through workouts, finding a way for me to get better. You know, seeing him, how he's wired, just helped me just become better and be a better athlete all around.
So what's life like at home?
Well, I come from a sports family, so everything is based around sports. If we're not watching them, we at games or playing them, you know, so everything. But like I told you, I come from a basketball family, so me playing football is a little different. Everybody comes to the games, but, you know, it's a little different because it's not really the sport that we used to seeing or whatever. So, but it's fun, though. I like playing a different sport than what everybody played in the family, so I like it.
You also play varsity basketball.
Yes, sir.
Tell us a little bit about that. What does that do? That helps you keep you in shape?
Yeah, definitely. Keep me in shape. Keep my feet fast. Keep my feet quick. That's the biggest thing, staying in shape. Because, you know, after football season, you don't really start training again for another month or two. So during that month or two, I'm still running, active, quick feet, quick on my feet, stuff like that. So that's the biggest part for me.
So you never were nervous, you know, I mean, because your big thing, obviously, big ticket's football.
Yeah.
You were never really nervous these past 3 years playing basketball?
No, not really. My dad always told me, you know, when you take stuff serious, you know, if you don't take stuff serious, you might get hurt. So I just tried to take it serious and give it all I had, you know, as if it was my main sport. So I feel like, you know, I wasn't really worried about that.
So how do you spend your free time when you, like, away from the game?
Yeah, away from the game. Watching a lot of tape, watching a lot of film of people I like to watch, my favorite players. I love to watch Aaron Donald. He got his own YouTube channel. I watch a lot of Aaron Donald. I like watching movies too. I watch a TV series. I hang with my friends. I like playing board games too. I love playing Monopoly. It's one of my favorite games ever. Me and my friend, we play Monopoly a lot. But other than that, you know, I just watch a lot of tape, try and get better even when I'm not on the field.
I didn't know Aaron McDonald had a YouTube.
Oh, yes, dude.
Is he mean or is he?
Nah, he's a cool dude, man.
That's only on the field?
Yeah, he's a real family man. Got his kids with him all the time. He's cool. It's a cool YouTube channel. I like watching it.
So what does family, community mean to you?
It means a lot. You know, I feel like I'm doing a lot of this for me, but most of it's for my family, you know, so we can, you know, have a better life, you know, because my end goal is to make it to the NFL. So, you know, with that being said, I just want to keep working hard for them and for the community so I can get back once it's all said and done. So it means a lot to me.
So touching on your family a little bit more, you got a little brother.
Yeah, there.
He's a bad boy on that basketball
yes,
court.
Yes, sir. Best player in the country.
Tell me what you think about when you think about your brother.
He keep going, he will, but as long as he keep working hard and keep pushing himself to limits he didn't think existed, man, he's going to be a bad boy, man. He's going to go to the league and he's going to be one of the best players ever was, I think, in my opinion.
And he's dunking already, right?
What, yeah,
eighth grade?
Eighth grade, yes, sir.
I mean, really dunking. Now, right. You know, some kids are, they getting it up over the rim, but he's flushing.
He's really dunking it now. Yes, sir.
All right, okay. So let's jump to the big question now. That W you got on your shirt, man.
Yes, sir.
University of Wisconsin.
Yes, sir.
Tell us a little bit about your commitment, you know, why you committed to Wisconsin, because you had, I mean, you had dozens of offers, even Alabama, right?
Right, yes, sir.
Why Wisconsin?
Wisconsin for me because it felt most like home, more than anything, felt more like home. I got a good feel for the people in the city when I was on my visits, and I had been there a lot. You know, I had been there 3 times, you know, unofficial visits. I didn't get a chance to take my official because of all the COVID stuff, but felt like home, felt like family, and I feel like I'm having an opportunity to play, you know, at an early stage of my career there. You know, and I like the system they play. You know, I'm gonna be playing outside backer, not really defensive end, somewhat defensive end, but I get to drop in the coverage a little bit more. So everything was just, I feel like, right for me. From the time I stepped on campus, everything just felt right. I feel like they got a good plan for me as well, so that was a big thing.
We know the Big Ten, that's a gritty conference.
Right.
We see offense, but defenses are more the main staple of Big Ten
right.
football, so I can see why you chose that.
Yes,
so now as far as the transition from, wipe that B off your neck. Yeah, I want you to get started. As far as the transition from defensive end to outside linebacker, what have you been doing to get yourself ready to play that position? I know you mentioned your feet and everything.
Right. Yeah, like keeping my feet quick. You know, like I told you, I'm going to be dropping the coverage a lot more than usual. So just making sure my feet stay quick, being able to cover, you know, more than likely tight ends or running backs, working on that. I do some of that stuff in practice now, I'm hoping, but, you know, just making sure, you know, because college is a different level, different animal. People are faster, quicker, stronger. So making sure I can keep up with that. Coverages and stuff, just keeping my feet quick, keeping my hips loose and stuff like that.
Okay. How are you going to feel? I mean, you being an Ohio kid,
yeah.
How are you going to feel when you line up against the Buckeyes?
That game, I'm going to come in with a chip on my shoulder more than anything because that was an offer I really wanted, you know, coming into the recruiting process and I didn't get it. So that game, it probably see a whole different animal.
Oh, so, you feel like you got something to prove, huh?
Definitely something to prove in that game.
All right. So let's talk about your future plans after football. So one, you said you want to go to the NFL, obviously.
Yes, sir.
What are you doing to prepare yourself for life after football?
Well, I plan to major in physical therapy to kind of, you know, I want to be around the game, you know, for a long time, even after my playing days are over. So hopefully be a team doctor or hopefully I get to, you know, be a coach, you know, after football. You know, I really enjoy being around the game. So just helping where I can and use the knowledge I get through my career to help others. Younger people after me, I would love to do that and be a coach. Okay.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful. A lot of kids, all they see is NFL,
right.
NBA, not really thinking about life after. Even if
Definitely.
You do make it,
right.
You know, hopefully, you know, you'll live a long life.
That's yes, sir.
Yeah. So, let's talk a little bit about Hoban. You know, you're playing at Hoban now, very prestigious school. You guys in the past years, you know, past 3 years have done something phenomenal. I mean, you've won multiple state championships.
Right.
You've been in competition every year.
Right.
Talk a little bit about what that means for you.
It's really preparing me for college, I think, more than anything, being at Hoban. You know, we're wired like a college, I feel. You know, with college atmosphere during practice, our coaches treat us as if we're college athletes already. So they're preparing us for the next level, you know, more than anything. You know, we our program, you know, from strength program to conditioning, you know, how everything really ran. You know, they're just treating us like young men, getting us ready for the next level.
What kind of advice has Coach given to you as far as your steps on the next level, how to succeed?
More than anything, he tells me to just continue to keep my same work ethic. He tells me if I continue to work, you know, as if I'm the underdog, you know, I'll be unstoppable.
We had this has been one crazy year.
Yeah.
At one point, you guys were wondering if you were going to have a season or not.
Right.
Just talk a little bit about how this pandemic has affected you, you know, the team, you know, your community.
For me, it affected me, you know, for the recruitment process more than anything, because I really wasn't able to take official visits like I wanted to. But as far as like workouts and stuff, I didn't really miss a beat. You know, I had found a place to work out when all this stuff was quarantined and stuff had just come about and everything shut down. So I was really, you know, staying working, staying, you know, but like more than anything, that's what really, you know, is the biggest thing, just not being able to take my official visits. You know, that was a big part. That's the biggest part, I think, in the recruiting process, being able to see everything, you know, head on for a whole weekend, spending the night and stuff. So other than that, you know.
How'd you keep yourself? What'd you do for our conditioning? How'd you keep yourself in shape?
Actually, I was on this exact field running sprints. I ran sprints like 2-3 times a week, trying to stay in shape, you know, and ran laps around tracks and different stuff like that, ran hills. That was the biggest thing.
There you guys have it, Darryl Peterson in many words.
Yes, sir.